Hi everybody, welcome to another fish keeping Jamaica rally here. I'm giving an update on my fish stock, what have been happening. Okay, so during the course of this week I went to my regular pet shop. The reason why it looks so green, I changed all water last week, right? So the reason why it's looking so green, sun is really hot and you have what you call algae bloom. So I went to the pet shop this week and I purchased mangano, a really large mangano. I'm not sure if I'll be able to see it in this pond, but it is here by itself. I bought two, a male and a female, but I only end up with one. It is about this big. Seriously, it's about nearly 6 inches long. It's the first I've actually, well, five and a half. It's the first time I've actually seen a mangano that large. That's the reason why I bought it. This video in essence is just to share with you my experience, right? I know I should know better, being that I'm a fish keeper, and I should know the traits of different type of fish. However, this is my problem. Well, this is what I experienced, right? So I went to the pet shop and I bought two, call it 5.5 inches fish. The attendant actually saw me the fish and actually placed both manganos in the same bag. By the time I reached home, I only had one mangano alive. It seems as if they were just too close for comfort, thus one eventually killed the other one with aggression, right? So this is just to share with you, whenever you go to a pet shop purchasing large fish, try to, although they might be of the same kind, male or female, try to get the attendant to place them in two separate containers, because the smaller the space, the more aggression dead. Okay, so in addition to my update, I have about three and a half inches chromite in this pond. I bought probably about 1.5 inches chromite, and it looks as if the tail was bitten off and the scales were just like, as if, you know, it was just ragged, like something actually tore through it. I do not know what to do with this chromite, because every single male in which I actually place with this fish, it's just tearing it apart, right? So I'm just lost for words right there. Now I am actually, as you can see, this breadfruit tree is actually growing tall, right? Which kind of leaves the leaves are not really stretching over the ponds anymore, it's going up. So this pond is actually left open to the harsh the harsh sunshine which occurs every day, right? I did top up last week and it seems as if I'm gonna have to be topping up again, because I'm losing water through evaporation. Okay, so that's it with my chromite, that's it with that pond. And as usual, wasps and bees continuously drink water. They don't bother me, I just do my thing. Okay, in this pond, last week I did not do anything much on my ponds outside. This week, I'm just giving you an update, right? I'm going to be dividing updating update one and update two. Okay, so what I did, I actually went into four or five of my swordtail ponds, and I've actually removed all swordtail that is over 1.5 inches in length, right? I've actually placed them in a pond where several other larger swordtail exist. So practically these are like juvies and real small babies, right? So juvies and small babies. Oh, and I have actually stripped the plants. That's why they are looking like this. I've actually stripped the plants of their dead leaves, and I've actually placed them back into the pond. But because they are a little bit unbalanced right now, you find that they are looking all at haphazardly placed in the pond, but in time they will curve themselves and actually become really nice looking. Okay, so I've removed the large fish from this one and this one. Okay, this pond has nothing in it. I'll be placing my curry cats in this pond in a few minutes. Yes, I'm taking out some of my fish from inside as I actually restructure my tanks inside. As you can see, I'm building new tanks and I will be placing some in back inside, but right now I am actually doing a restructuring program, so my fish will actually be in this one in short order. All right, so I have a pair of manganos in this pond. I did not change water nor strip the plants for this pond, right? I did with the sortie, so these fish are due some. Now, as you can see again, this pond, which has my demonsonis, and as usually hide a lot, it is actually experiencing a lot of evaporation, and I'm gonna have to top it up today. Now, be basking in the sun, what you have is that a lot of algae is actually growing on my plants. In this pond, I have some black skirt tetra, and I have tiger barb, and I don't remember the other two right now. I think, oh yeah, I have a ponder barb. I don't remember the other one, right? But this pond, water was changed last week, so I do not need to do that this week. Now this have about probably about 40 Jack Dempsey fries, in which I promised my neighbor to give him about 10. So I haven't seen him since morning, so I'm gonna be doing that. And I have some other updates about my Jack Dempsey around the corner. All right, this is my next pond in which this is my other pond in which I actually took out some of the larger ones, and now I have the smaller sorting. Right, I'm gonna be doing an exclusive sometime in the summer, I'm not sure exactly when, about sorting, because I have about 4 or 5 different types of sorting. So I'm gonna be looking at that in short order. So I removed some from here and from the other two below. I did not remove any from here, it never dawned on me, so therefore I have some large males in I have some large swordtails in this fish, in this pond, in which I will be removing them as soon as I'm on break, probably next 2 weeks from school, right? So there you have my swordtails, the adults, they're swimming around, right? So I'll be taking out those.